Well, happy Wednesday, everyone. If everything goes well in this build, this will come out on Wednesday afternoon. If not, it'll come on Saturday, and then you'll all correct me and say, wait a minute, it's not Wednesday. So anyways, that's how I film things. So we are going to be building up AMT's reissue of the 125th scale Ford Mustang II concept car from 1963. This thing has opening trunk, opening hood, opening doors. We're going to be building it up. It is the concept car. We've got some cool options in the box for it, even though they had just the one concept as far as I know. We're going to get some extra parts in here. We can decide how we want to build it up. It has 130 parts in the kit. It says real steering. It says working steering from the steering wheel down. Now, I don't know if I'm going to be able to build that up and make it work or if I'm just going to set it as it is. I also think it has a figure kit in the model. So let's start taking a look at the parts, see what we're going to get ourselves into. First, from the multimedia side of the table, we've got a set of Goodyear tires. They are a solid rubber vinyl. Got a nice tread pattern to them. They do say Goodyear all the way around on both sides. They've got the big Goodyear logos. You could probably do your own version of pad printing if you wanted those to be white letter tires. On the box art, it almost looks like it has white wall tires on it. So, oh, and it does, definitely. We can see on the side here the nice box art. It does have white wall tires on there, so you would have to replicate that. Let's see if they help you do that. We've got a set of glass here. We've got our side vents, back glass for the fastback, windshield glass, and convertible top glass, along with custom taillights on there. One steel axle. A nice set of chrome parts on the singular chrome tree. We've got the wheels that are pictured on the concept. These exact ones. And then they give you an option of mag wheels as well. So we've got the custom wheels, the mag wheels. Here's our vents for those opening doors because it is a convertible. Belt and pulley system, nice grill on there. Chrome air cleaner. We've got a stock-ish air cleaner. We've got our manifolds coming off the side in chrome. We've got the springs in chrome. I'm not going to like any of that. We've got our shocks in chrome. So this is all going to get installed and painted by me. I'm not a fan of any of that. We've got what looks like our custom headlight buckets, chrome exhaust system, mufflers right there. We've got our side vents, decoration vents on there. Knockoffs for the wheels. Moving on from the chrome tree, we have a beautiful new decal sheet printed on a blue background so we can actually see all the white stuff. That's kind of a newer one for AMT. Usually it's like a whiter background. We've got two sets of striping, white and blue. Blue will replicate that nice white model on the box art there. We've got some awesome, are these side panels that look like fake teak, like a boat hull? Obviously, there's our white walls. So we'll be able to replicate the white walls. We've got some number plates. We've got the number plates for the side and then numbers to go in them. We've got our gauges, interior, exterior emblems here. Love that the stripes have the Mustang logo on them. That's very sharp on there. We've got numerous contingency decals, license plates. These, I wonder what car these were on, these wood stripes there like that. I wonder what those are for. We'll have to take a look, see what the manual says when I start building. So we will move over to where everything else is molded in white styrene. On this tree here, we've got our optional luggage rack, our luggage package area in the back instead of a back seat. Got our hood with hood hinges. Got our convertible top. So we can build that, paint it, install the glass and put it on and remove it as we wish, same as opening the doors. Speaking of opening doors, we've got our interior door panels, highly detailed, cranks, levers, everything on there, the trim work, even the little logos on top are molded in. Then our exterior door panels, very crisp as well. I don't think this kit's been reissued very much. Door handles are very strong. Got our hinges, interior. I have to shave off a little bit of flash. Not a big deal at all. Nothing worth whining about, but some people will. Got our optional fastback top for that larger piece of glass. You can see the little vents in the side. Underneath, where the ejector pin marks are. Nice smooth molding on that. See how nice and glossy that optional top is? On this tree here. Oh yeah, there he is. There's our driver figure. Helmet and everything. Oh, that had to hurt. Was he hit by a railroad spike? Holy cow. So we've got the arms, legs, everything molded in there. Got our back seat. If you want to use the back seat instead of that package shelf. Got our front seats. Got our interior door panels for the rear, or just interior panels. Here's all the hookups for our hinges on everything. Hood, trunk, doors. Got our trunk panel. Ooh, nice molding on it. I wasn't expecting that. Nice molding underneath the trunk panel. Got our concept dashboard. Round gauges for those decals. The one I saw, the upper part, so above where the gauges and there and across and all the top was blue and then the bottom was white. I'm going to try to replicate that. Same as the seats, since they're out of the vehicle and the back seat isn't molded into the tub. I'm going to try to replicate that on mine as best I can in the time allowed. We got front and rear body panels. These look like butt fits. So we'll see how well we can attach those once we wrap that around the chassis. Got the seat back come loose there. So that's our parts tree there. On here, we've got our small block V8. Transmission halves. Battery. Optional intakes. We got our single carburetor or 3-2 barrels. Cylinder heads. Oil pan. Timing chain. Fuel pump. Wheel backs. Looks like a little scoop here. Possibly optional hood scoop. Radiator. Front frame of the vehicle. Got a hat. Well, thank goodness, because we got to cover that guy's head up. We got a nice little cowboy hat there. Optional custom steering wheel, super custom steering wheel, and stock steering wheel for the concept. I like that that's molded in there. That looks pretty cool, though. I like that that's molded in there with all the little holes and everything on both of them. It's really interesting. One piece differential and drive shaft. Well, that steel axle will fit through there. Go to our Mustang body. That's quite delicate, so be very, very careful. You'll have to cut a lot of this stuff off. Maybe I'll leave those on so I can paint the body without putting one of my body spreaders in it. I'm worried about breaking some of that stuff. And then the reinforcing points are molded inside the doors and on the back of the visors with the hood brace. So we might be able to get that painted with the braces in it and not have to worry about breaking stuff too easy. I know that a lot of the suspension and steering are all chrome. We're going to cut this out. Do not cut those little tabs. That's for your hood. And finally, we get to the chassis. Last of the 130 parts on there. We can see our suspension, steering, kingpins, and everything are going to go in there. Spindles. We can see where our exhaust is going to be mounting in. Our rear springs will be mounting in. We're going to be gluing that stuff in and painting it because I'm not a fan of those chrome parts at all. I like it to look a little more natural. Maybe they were chrome in the real thing. We got our interior here. On the concept pictures that I saw, this was like a gray, so we can use like a gray primer over the black primer that I'll use to shadow. And then we're going to probably have to hand paint the console because this was interior color like a white and then this was all a blue, so it's going to be kind of complex, but we will get to work on it. We'll see what we can do. I'm going to start gluing mine together and I'll see you in just a little bit. Hello friends, as you saw, we had multi-piece surgery on the kit. We did have to do a little more cleaning up, so I showed the parts where I work with the knife. It's not hard at all. There's nothing that has to be re-carved or re-scribed or anything. Just had to open up the holes on the intake for the three two-barrel carburetors. I like a six-pack intake, so that's why I decided to use it on this one. I don't know if it's perfectly prototype correct, and I don't care either. So I want to put it on there. It's on the kit. It's available. That's what I'm going to do. I've assembled everything, and then I've gone over to my wash bin, and I've cleaned up the body parts, hood, top, doors, body panels, dashboard, trunk panel, all that stuff with Simple Green. Just scrubbed it with an old toothbrush, rinsed it off with hot water, and we are ready to paint. So before we get to paint, we'll look at what we've assembled so far. Got the body clean. We've got the chassis here. As you know, I'm not a huge fan of chrome everything, so this will get painted up. Now, the front suspension did assemble easier than I thought. It took a little bit to get everything together, as you saw. I do it in real time, so you're watching me assembling it. I don't speed it up or anything like that. So you'll see if I get a little frustrated with a part or if I have to open a hole or something like that, but it did go together. The spindles fit in the holes super, super tight. Now, I don't want my stuff to move around, so that's fine for me. If you want to have working steering, you are going to need to open the upper and lower holes in the chrome suspension arms and in the uppers. Excuse me. You will need to open those holes in the top and the bottom, just like I even needed to open some of the holes further for the chromed coil springs. You will need to open those holes up so that you can steer. Also, on the instruction manual, you will want to pay attention. And as I was assembling it, they have the chassis laying upside down, like so. So I orient it like that when I build, and they have you installing the steering point on the passenger side. You see that? The chassis is upside down. They have it on the passenger side. The little bump out here is your clue. So when I was done with mine, since I didn't glue this together, it holds tight all on its own. I was able to remove it and switch it around, and that little holder there should line up with the hole in the firewall, so that your steering arm can go down. Once it goes through the dashboard, this will all fit through the hole in the dashboard. So it can go down, and you gently move it under there. And then, this can be very hard to do with hands like this in this position, but it will clip into there. So you'll see where it attaches into there. You'll see me pull it out, and then it'll kind of go over it like so. You know, it'll go in there through that little crimp. It'll snap in place. So that's how you want it. You need, of course, this is a Mustang built by Ford in the United States back in the 60s. So it will have the drive on the left-hand side. Got our chrome suspension arms installed with our spindles. And if you open up those holes, I mean, I can move it, but it's really tight. And I don't want to break it. So I'm just glad that it's in there and straight. Then on the one spindle, as you saw, I did have to snip off a little bit. It was pushing the spindle out and giving it, the front wheel would have been like, wah, leaning in at the top. So I did trim that off and then just super glued all the chrome parts in, glued the front of the frame on, and then I glued the leaf springs on. And pay attention that in front of the leaf spring, the area here where the shock will mount, the little indentation, is forward. And I got that information from looking at the picture. The forward part is in front of the axle, towards the front of the car. And then you'll be able to mount your... Now, I'll leave the coil springs as chrome because they'll look nice and those are easy to attach. So we'll leave those as chrome for a little bit of detail underneath. And silver-colored shocks were extremely normal all the time. We've got our little engine built up here. I'll leave the manifolds chrome and attach them later. There's a large enough divot in here on the cylinder heads to do so. Got our starter molded in, distributor molded in, so that don't turn that upside down. That's not a fuel pump. So fuel pump should be right there, I think, is what they're wanting it to be. Got our long transmission in there, and I made sure that it would all slide into the chassis when we were done, so I didn't have anything screwed up. As you saw, I assembled the steering wheel. I assembled Slenderman's uncle. That'll probably get the video flag. This gangly arm goes down to the shifter. This gangly arm goes to the steering wheel. I'm probably just going to primer him, and so you can see what it looks like and stick it in the car if it fits right. But yeah, whoo, Those are like the MPC snowspeeder figures. Not so hot. And then they have an insert for his helmet. And I didn't bother sanding it down or anything. So you could actually paint that a color, like the blue, you know, on the stripe, just like they have it on the box. Because it looks kind of cool that way. So you could do that up for the figure. Whatever you want to do. He's supposed to be white anyways to begin with the blue interior. On the box art, you can see the seats are blue. And then the front of the seats is blue and the back is white. On a different car that I saw, they had the blue down the center of the seats, and these front seats assemble really nicely. They even fold forward. I don't have a drop of glue on these because I thought if I decided to two-tone the seats, it would be easier to be able to snap them apart after I painted them white, snap them apart and mask off and paint the blue. So that's why you didn't see me glue those together. The rear seats shouldn't be too hard to mask. I mean, we'll do, you know, the white down the center maybe, or maybe I'll do them all blue like they do on the box art. You know, because we'll be surrounding it with a white body. Maybe. It all depends on what, you know, what you want to do with your model. So we don't have anything to assemble on here. We just have a radiator, wheelbacks, glued the centers of the wheelbacks in so that they mount up on the front spindles. We got that hat. They paint the hat, throw it on the passenger seat for the driver when he gets off with his helmet. And then I assembled the doors, which required a little bit of clamping. No big deal. Pushed them in tight, cleaned them up, clamped them up. And we will get those mounted on the car. So at this point, I'm going to let everything dry from being washed, and then I will get it over into the spray booth, and I'll see you there.
Thank you. Thank you.
taking a look at my custom Mustang. I've got the taillights set up to be installed. Did the two outer in red and the centers in clear. And that's the manual says to do them in red and clear. It didn't say exactly how to break them up. But when you were looking through the instruction manual, as it just said clear, paint clear red, taillights. So I just mixed up some on mine. I couldn't find any pictures of a taillights on a Mustang, so did them up like so. We've got our exhaust tips that are going to go in here. The little chrome exhaust tips are hiding. Where'd they go on here? They're on the chrome tree, and there they are. They're reversed. They look like just a blank panel from the other side, but they're actually right there. So that's where that'll go in the bumper. We've got our side trim on the car to go on. We've got our headlight covers to go on and some very small other pieces to stick on once we get the car together. We've got our convertible top sitting on there so you can see what it's going to look like when we're all done. Then we've got our body together. I've got the doors in. I've got the hinges glued in. I used just a single hinge for the doors instead of doubling them up. I just used a single on there, which allows me to move the door around a lot more to line it up with the body correctly and attach it. We don't have anything anywhere near a perfect alignment on all that stuff. This scale and this vintage of a kit, it would take an extensive amount of work to get those doors to line up absolutely perfectly and operate perfectly. Time that I don't have, but these reviews aren't about building the perfect model. They never are, even though some of you watch this and I say that and you still say it in the comments. Well, that's a perfectly show accurate. That's not what it's supposed to be. These are just to show you what's in the kit, how it goes together in a general sense of putting it together and whatnot. So we've got the doors all lined up. The passenger door lines up on mine better than the driver's door, but with some whittling of plastic and messing around, I'm sure you could get the driver's side door to line up a little bit better on the front end. I did remove a little bit of plastic on the door panel to try to get that to line up better, but if we still want them to open, it's never going to be perfect without a ton of rework. We've got the windshield in, that glues in very nicely. I painted the visors by hand, got our vent visors, got our windshield wipers, and then you even saw me add the little wiper blades. Got our grill. Now, this isn't staying on when we mount it to the chassis. The grill will come out, and I just wanted you to see that mounted in there. These would normally be clear, but with such a white body, I wanted to add a little bit of, you know, the parking lights with the amber in them, so you saw how I did that. But that's just going to pull off so that we can get this curved over body onto the chassis. I've got the trunk attached. And with the trunk attached, I did use the single hinges on there like it does. I did use some soft tape, some frog tape on there to hold the trunk in place. When I'm trying to put the body on and stuff, I don't need this flopping around and getting in the way or getting damaged. But yeah, it does sit flat. We can see that it sits nice in there once we hold it all completely down and the hinges held it in place. The hood was very, very difficult to fit. I ended up having to sand off the sides and everything and trim everything down. And for the hood, since I want to be able to display it, I'm just going to friction fit it. I'm not going to hinge it. I did remove the hinge completely and sanded it down and finally got it to fit in there correctly and worked it over. So when we get all that installed, then I will install the side lights on the glass. Just this little chrome lip, this thin chrome area here, will push down inside each side and glue in place. And to hold that in, I will use clear tacky glue. Not only will it hold it from the start in position, but if you drip this on the body or get it anywhere you don't want it, it will not ruin anything. It will not turn anything opaque. It will not fog anything up. And that's why I like using this quite a bit for stuff like that. So that's all set to go. Then we've got our chassis. I use the black hat there as a little nod to Carroll Shelby and his Mustangs. Got the interior done, masked off all of that stuff and did all that work. Even two-toned the dashboard, got the dash decals in place, got the little shifter done, got our seats, got our wheels attached. The wheels went on super easy on this kit, nothing to worry. Absolute minimal detail underneath. Glued the exhaust in place, the mufflers, painted the drive shaft, and that's it. Not doing any more fuel tank, nothing. Just leaving it. It's very plain Jane to begin with, so I left it, but you can see how nicely the exhaust drops in, lines up. with our Ford engine, which of course in the early 60s probably would have been black, but we're doing a blue on white car. I did a more Ford blue on there, got the belt and pulley system, got the radiator in there, and we're looking tight. I also, since the trunk opened, went in and painted the trunk a little darker gray than the interior carpet. So I painted that. And then we've got our figure. If you decided you want to use them, that's how it's going to look. You can do a little sanding, a little painting, but in primer, that's how the little dude's going to look, with his hand down by the shifter, his other hand on the steering wheel, and that's it. So if you decide to detail that figure, you will have that all set. Once we get it final assembled, I've got to drop this on, attach my side lights, push the grill on. The tail lights will just slide in into place and hold everything, and I'll use some more of that tacky glue to do that. So once that's attached, put the grill in, hood on, I will then stripe it and put the small Mustang emblems on, and we will call this one a final. So I'll see you in a little bit. Well, that wraps up this build of the 1963 Ford Mustang II concept car, and I hope you enjoyed it. This kit, I will tell you immediately, is not for beginners. You're going to want to know what you're doing. You're going to want to get things together and be able to deal with some adjustments at the end because of the side panels for the rear, the doors, the hood, the trunk, the posable steering that actually works with the steering wheel if you don't glue it together. You're going to want to take your time and know how to problem solve. It's not just going to fall together and go absolutely perfect every single time. It's very hard to get that with a kit that's this size with all these moving and extra functions on them. Now, the kit itself goes together relatively well. I mean, when I say relatively well, I mean it doesn't have any major defects or anything like that going on. But when you go to put that body on the chassis, you definitely need to pay attention to what you're doing, and you're going to want to go slow. Now, I ended up having to remove just a little bit of material on the far sides of the dashboard, remove the interior again, and fix that up, and then reinstall it into the body and squeeze the body around it. And then we got it all together. Now, the decals laid down without issue, and I was able to slice them with my razor knife so I can still open the trunk and the hood for the final pictures. I've got one door open, one door closed, so you can see the difference on there, what it looks like. I did a two-tone interior about as close as I could see to the box art. It doesn't look like the ones I've seen online, but it does somewhat resemble the box art with the blue and white dash, blue seats that are mostly blue with the singular white stripe down the center, the blue console towards the front. Did a lot of masking on that. Final assemblies for the grill, the nose, and the taillight section and the headlights were not a problem at all. They all went in. They pretty much friction fit, but I did use some super glue just to make sure that they didn't go anywhere. On the back of the car, I used more of the Aleene's clear gel tacky glue because I did not want to get super glue on those translucents part and end up ruining it. We can always put our top that I've got all set up here with the glass on it. We can set that on there so you can see what it looks like with the top on park like that. I mean, it's definitely a Mustang. You're not going to mistake it for anything else. So it looks pretty cool that way. But taking it off gives us the full complement. We can see the blue striping package all the way around, and it even goes underneath the nose. We got that big, what I call suckerfish nose on there that they changed for some Mustangs. We've got the six taillights, which we know are definitely Mustang. We've got our little visors on there, our low sloop windshield, which was stood up a little more for the real thing. We've got all of those cool parts. We got these racing mirrors out on the fenders. So it's a pretty cool looking car. I mean, it's definitely different, and it's definitely going to draw attention on the shelf or at a model show if you take the time to get all the doors and the trunk and the hood to work absolutely perfect. And you can reach in here and turn the steering wheel and use it to turn the front wheels. That's pretty interesting and something that's not extremely common on a plastic model kit in 1/25th scale. So I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this beautiful little kit over. I had a good time with it. It does take some time to get that body on at the end, and we had one mishap with the decals. I'm going to say it's my fault because it only happened with one. Was the one of the white walls just kind of didn't work at all. So I've got three white walls on there. Made sure I'll be able to take the pictures from the one side with the white walls, but on the driver's side at the rear, it's just a black wall now. I could not get that thing to cooperate. It kept folding in on itself and messing up, but the rest of the decals worked absolutely beautiful, laid down. Even the sweet Mustang II decals on the fenders, little decal solvent, and they smushed right down over the molded in Mustang II logos. So thanks to Round 2 Models for sending this over. I will link in the description where you could snag yours. This should be available right now or should be coming quite soon. Thank you all, and I'll see you at the next review.